To me, she was my princess, but along came her knight. She told us she had met somebody and she wanted to bring him over. Over comes the knight riding in his pickup truck. Josh is talking and socializing, and I can see a glimmer in my princess's eyes. And at that moment, I knew my princess had found her knight.
Sophia has always been into poems and literature more than I have, but here's my best attempt at a little poetry myself. Today you said I do to the one that stole your heart. I speak to you as one because you'll never be apart. It's not every day a hypochondriac marries an MD, but now you can forever be worry-free. Josh, I'm so honored that I get to be your first sister. And so happy that I got to stand beside you as you became Mrs. and Mr. And it blessed my soul. Sophia, you're my best friend. But I guess I can share. Just make sure you always have a toothbrush for me to spare. And Josh, I know you used my toothbrush.
I've had the privilege of knowing Josh for nearly 10 years. The entire time we've been traveling parallel, he's always been just a little bit ahead of me. So he went to college a year before me, medical school a year before me. He's even going to finish his fellowship now at the Cleveland Clinic before me. You know, I've always had to look up to him, both literally and figuratively. Josh is also an only child, so wherever he goes, Josh makes a big family around him. Today, he's gained a huge family to be a part of for the rest of his life.
My Sophia was born about 31 years ago this same week, and it changed my life. It seems like yesterday. She was beautiful. She was perfect in every way.
My joy to be a part of your wedding. One of the things that a visitor to our church first notices is the bride and groom don't talk. And so people always ask, why? Where were the vows? Why didn't they say anything? And the honest goodness truth is that we believe that the bride and groom have pledged their love to one another, that they've probably done it repeatedly over time. And we make a mention of that in church because there's one of the prayers early on in the service where we ask God to confirm the word that they have spoken to one another. But honestly, we assume that you came to church on this day at this time, dressed like you are. We assume the answer is yes. So what we try to emphasize in church is the aspect of sacrament, the idea that of marriage is a gift from God.
First of all, congratulations. It is with a great honor that I was able to be here to serve the wedding. And it is something that none of us can do. It's not something that Father Stephen and I can do or Deacon Tom can do, is to make you married. We're not the ones who do that. It is God above who is able to do that. And it was very inspiring. I was blessing the crowns. I was able to look up and see Christ above us in the icon. The reality of that presence being in your life now, in some mystical and unbelievable way, the two of you have been made one.
It was a joy to be a part of your life. I'm glad that God brought you to Cleveland for however long God keeps you in Cleveland. And it was a joy, and I hope you have many fond memories of Cleveland wherever life takes you. God bless you with long life and happiness. Nazisita. Want to kiss her?
Josh, you make my sister the happiest I've ever seen. I can't tell you how happy I am to add you to our family tree. Let tonight continue to be a fairy tale ending to an amazing day. Let's get on with the toast. What do you say? Please raise your glass for a toast to the bride and groom. Sophia and Josh, I love you with all my heart. Congratulations on your wedding day. When times get tough, remember this day. May the vows you spoke last an eternity and the love in your eyes never fade. May you forever be as happy as you are today.
We too fell in love with Josh. His easy manner and welcoming spirit shine right through this big, loud Pappin family. And that's hard to do. May God fulfill all of your hopes and dreams of tomorrow. And may your love and happiness be everlasting. It is now my pleasure to propose a toast to the happy couple, Mr. and Mrs. Knight.
Josh is a talented guy, enthusiastic in whatever pursuit he was going after. But once he met Sophia, he's seemed different. He seemed calmer, complete, like he's found his other half. You know, they say that marriage is not about finding a person you can live with. It's about finding the person you can't live without. And Josh and Sophia have done that. So it's my great honor to be his best man tonight. I'd like to raise one more glass in their honor and to many more happy years to come.